It's a topic that gets many of you hot under the collar. How best to accommodate cyclists in our cities? In Wellington, councillors have approved an additional 5 kilometres of cycle lane in Kilburnie and Thorndon, part of a 166-kilometre project throughout the city. So what are the pros and cons of cycle lanes? To debate the issue in Wellington, we've got Patrick Morgan from the Cycling Action Network. And in Christchurch, City Councillor Aaron Keown joins us this morning. Morena Cordua, thank you so much for being with us. Patrick, first of all, let's start with you. You must be so pleased to see this money from the Wellington City Council injected into the city for cycle lanes.
Yeah, atamarie, Matty. It's good to see you. I had a great day yesterday. Wellington City has got momentum. There's a race in cities all around the world to decarbonise transport and keep people safe. So it's great to see Wellington City make good progress.
Is it a good value for money, do you think?
Look, absolutely. Biking projects are the best bang for buck in transport. They deliver far more benefits than costs. So that's why smart cities are investing in cycling and micro-mobility lanes.
Aaron, let's come to you in Christchurch. This is obviously, we're talking specifically about this situation in Wellington here, but this is a national project that a lot of councils are dealing with at the moment. And it costs, hundreds of thousands of dollars city councils are spending on cycle lanes at the moment. Do you think it's a good investment?
Hundreds of millions, Maddie, is how much they're spending on cycleways. Is it a good investment? Investing in cycleways is a great investment if they're in the right place and designed for all road users, not just for the cyclists. The overspending is not a great investment. In fact, the amount we're spending on cycleways has gone way out of whack. We were meant to only spend $67 million in Christchurch to deliver all of our cycleways, our entire network, and do it in 5 years. It's taken twice as long. We're halfway there and spent six times as much.
Although, are we only overspending at the moment because we've been underspending significantly for such a long time and now we're playing catch-up?
No, absolutely not. For many years, people in Christchurch cycled and cycled a lot, and a lot of real cyclists contact me all the time and say that they are more than happy just to cycle on the road. In fact, question why these cycleways are being over-engineered in the way that they are. And when you go to other cities around the world, and I've cycled in some pretty cool cities, including New York, they're nothing like what we've done here. And I think ours are over the top, and we're spending way too much money, and that's not the best way to get people on bikes. And if you're spending money to save the planet, you're wasting it currently doing it that way. There's much better ways we could be saving the planet.
So, Patrick, why are some cyclists desperate for cycleways? Because Aaron's saying that a lot of cyclists are saying to him they're quite happy to cycle on the roads. So why do we need the cycleways?
Sure. First, Aaron, I want to give you a lot of credit for advocating for bike lanes in Christchurch. Christchurch is the envy of New Zealand cities. The 13 major cycling routes are sparking a revolution in how people get around. And we've seen 40% increase in cycling in the last 6 or 7 years. Secondly, look, it may work for you, Aaron, but let's check our privilege here. This is not about building bike lanes for fearless, confident men who like riding bikes. And I have to say, the major cycling routes in Christchurch have seen an increase in diversity. 40% of people using them are women. Now, that's a really good indication that you're doing it right. So keep going.
And Aaron, you touched on a place like New York, right? Let's take a city like that, for example. This is a city that has consistently had cyclists through their cities. We are a little bit slower on the uptake, right? So perhaps things aren't quite as safe for cyclists on the road here as they would be overseas.
No, we have consistently had cyclists on the road in Christchurch. Look, one of the problems we have is constantly telling everyone cycling's dangerous. And to get your funding for your pet project to signal that you're saving the world, you are telling everyone cycling's dangerous. That will not get parents putting their kids on bikes to send them to school. Constantly saying it is that cycling is not dangerous. Cycling is fun and cycling is cool. What is dangerous is over-engineering cycleways, making roads more dangerous for all users, and congesting traffic. In fact, since we started putting in our network and saving the planet, we've increased our carbon footprint here in Christchurch. The opposite is happening.
Why do cycleways make it more dangerous for all road users? I don't understand your logic there.
because you will often take a two-lane road, a really good two-lane road, cut it down into one. We've had that happen now with Park Terrace in Christchurch under the guise of a temporary traffic management plan, which is just out of control. Herewood Road, which is 18,000 vehicles a day, will be now squeezed down into one lane, which increases your carbon footprint of 18,000 vehicles by an extra 2.5 minutes per day will be their extended travel time. That's unacceptable. When there's only a number of people that are too scared to ride on the road, once you have more people cycling, you will motorists will be more used to seeing cyclists, so it makes a safer environment. We need to spend the money on getting people cycling, not necessarily just building hard infrastructure. And I don't think that's winning them over.
But cycleways, Aaron, are not just about making people feel safer. It's about providing a smoother, faster, more efficient way for people to get out of the city, get into the city on their bikes, so it gets them out of the cars and decreases our carbon footprint.
Yeah, Matty, you sound like you've been to university and indoctrinated into that thinking. And yes, that's the way some people feel and think, but the majority of our public don't feel that way, and they're not being taken on the journey. And I'm upset that we are doing damage to cycling by putting people off the activity by doing it to them and not doing it with them. You need to take everyone on this journey. And cycling, like I said, is fun and cool. It is not this thing for that lot over there that are going to impose it on everyone else. And that's what is happening, and that is what is upsetting people.
Patrick, what do you say to that?
No, that's rubbish, Aaron. Look, we agree that cycling is cool and fun. We also know, again, from Christchurch, your own city, that when you build quality infrastructure, it makes the streets look good. People flock to it. That's why you've got a 40% increase in cycling over the last 6 or 7 years. You know, step outside, look on the streets. The evidence is there. We know that protected bike lanes make streets safer, not just for people on bikes, but for everyone, whether you're driving on foot or taking public transport. So, you know, keep going in Christchurch. You're doing a good thing, and I think, you know, you're reaping the benefits already. And let's remember, the Climate Commission has just said, let's keep investing in cycleways. Let's complete the networks. So I have two ideas for Grant Robertson in the budget next week. Number one, we should support people to get bikes, cargo bikes, e-bikes, with a subsidy in the same way that we support the transition to EVs. Number two, do like they're doing in France, pay people to ride bikes. It's so good for you, you'll get a good return on that investment. I'm serious, Patrick, about this.
I love your passion, Patrick. That's Patrick Morgan from the Cycle Action Network and Aaron Keown from Christchurch City Council. Thank you so much, both of you, for being with us this morning. Really appreciate your time.
Thanks, mate.
Kia ora, kia ora.